film segala macam, individual, taktik, strategik, semuanya tuh saya komunikasikan sama Hakim.
Yo, what's up school fans and welcome back to the vlog. We are here at Laga Tangkas super early though guys. Gila, gue 3 jam sebelum game udah nyampe. Belum pernah sih gue se-early itu, tapi it's gonna be a fun night di mana kita akan menonton IBL Playoff Game 1 antara Dewa United and the home team Borneo Hornbills. Man, kayaknya bakal banyak banget ini expression, emotion. Wah, game-nya sih kayaknya ini soalnya pemain-pemainnya kayak Akim Scott, Michael sebenarnya ekspresif banget sih. Jadi juga kita gak lupa dengan Gelfi Solano and Jordan Adams. I think it's gonna be so much fun tonight. And Lester Prosper, shout out to my boy though, Lester Prosper. So, can't wait though, super excited. And once again guys, thank you so much for watching. Jangan lupa untuk like, jangan lupa untuk comment. And please watch the vlog, the whole video. Appreciate you guys and enjoy the vlog.
Kita nyampe di Laga Tangkas, langsung support Uncle Akim dulu nih. How before you eat. Ini merchnya dia nih di sini nih. So, gua beli 5 biji 5 pieces untuk giveaway for my members. Let's go.
We got the man, man. You know?
We here, man. Look, 8th seed. You come here to try to make history. You come here to make history, baby. Y'all know the rules. How before you eat.
Get the merch, guys. Get the merch.
Yeah, you got to get the merch.
Yeah.
And don't get me walking into the table. You gotta cut that out.
Okay.
Definitely, bro. Appreciate you, my
guy. I appreciate
guy.
You, man.
Yo, love, love.
2 jam setengah sebelum game, Mike Wolf guys udah mulai nembak-nembak pemanasan. Dia tadi datang duluan juga untuk warming up before game 1. Di sini juga ada Uncle Akim yang lagi pemanasan sama Junet as well, working on his threes before the game. Probably gonna shoot a lot of threes though in tonight's game.
Good luck, coach. What's up, G? Good luck, man. Deep failure. Prosper. Oh, Joel lagi nunjukin video ke Jordan Adams. Scouting report probably on the tonight's game.
My brother Juwado just hit that motherfucking three.
Oh yeah, hell yeah.
Let's go!
Mas Willy nih. Pakai timeout, geng. Jersey. Let's go, Mas Willy. Oh, that was close. Hampir dari Mas Willy, Mas. Maga, gimana nih game 1 nih?
Puas kita, nggak rugi kita dari Pontianak jauh-jauh ke sini. Game 2 baby, game 2! Let's go!
Look at Steve though. Talk your shit after the win, bro.
I told you when I first got here, what I tell you. We're the team to watch out for, I told you. Nobody want to play us. Nobody.
Pasti ya kita kecewa semua sih. Kalau kita mikirnya mau swing, kita mau mikirnya kejauhan gitu ya. Akhirnya ya terbukti gitu. Nah, kita ternyata game tadi gitu ya, kita kalah. Kalah sama mereka lebih malu. Gak soal taktik gitu. Kalau untuk gue sih tadi gak soal taktik. Mereka lebih mau daripada kita, itu aja sih. Jadi ya nanti di game berikutnya mau nggak mau ini dua dari game kita, jadi mau nggak mau kita harus sekolah, harus benar-benar mati-matian lah gitu istilahnya.
For coach, how do you raise the players' mentality after this game?
Right now, we need to focus on the next game. Whatever happens tonight is over. Of course, there's a lot of tactical things we have to improve, but they have to clear their minds and think in the next 48 hours because that's the only chance we have.
Coach, what is it so tough to stop Akeem Scott tonight?
I think Akeem Scott played a great overall game on the offensive end. First of all, he was very aggressive driving the ball to the hoop. Every time he drove to the basket, he managed to score. Whether it be on the open court or on the half court, and also his shot fell. He shot very good, shot 2 for 5 in threes, which is 40%, which is very high. So his impact, 17 points in 18 minutes, shows that he played with a lot of aggressiveness on the offensive end.
Will you emphasize energy for the next game for the guys?
I think everything. We need everything. We didn't deserve to win tonight. They deserved the game. They wanted the game more than us. So we have to overall, everything we have to do, we have to do it better.
Thank you, coach.
First half, sama-sama baca situasi kali ya. Mereka ngapain, kita ngapain. Second half, kita bisa limit skor dia. Terus kita bisa tetap seperti apa yang first half kita lakuin. Terus di akhir itu kita menang sih, di game.
For Mike, how's tonight's game?
I just think we executed the game plan well. We had a long time to prepare for this game, you know what I mean? Even before, even when we knew that we qualified for playoffs, we had 2 weeks to play Pereira, you know, and we really even wasn't even focusing on them because, you know, that game didn't even matter. So we already had their way, you know, on our minds for almost a month now, you know what I mean? So we watched all their tendencies, we know what they like to do, we know what we wanted to live with, and you know, it just ended up working today. You know, we know they got size, so we just tried to have a collective effort on the rebounds. We know that they want to score, so we wanted to stick to the shooters and allow certain other people to shoot, you know.
Apakah coach kaget dengan penampilan dari Akeem?
Iya dan tidak sih, karena gini ya, di persiapan sebelum kita lawan Prawira, dari sebelum persiapan sebelum lawan Prawira tuh setiap hari saya komunikasi sama Akeem di lapangan latihan kami, apa yang harus kita lakuin, ini fokus kita lawan Prawira atau kita ganti fokus kita langsung lawan Dewa, dan itu dilakukan setiap hari. Breakdown semua film segala macam individual taktik strategik semuanya tuh saya komunikasikan sama Akeem. Apa yang dia kasih lihat di game hari ini saya nggak kaget gitu, karena dia prepare dia sendiri. Kita start practice at 9, right? Dia udah di lapangan 7:30.
Wow. You understand?
Yeah. 7:30 dia udah di lapangan. Work ethic apa yang dikasih, apa yang dikasih lihat ke pemain lokal lainnya itu yang dan terbukti malam ini. Itu Chess enggak kaget.
Okay, thank you coach. Mike, you and Akeem came like almost 3 hours before the game. Was it like planned? Or?
Nah, you know, of course, you know, Akeem is older, so he always gets here early, you know, just to get his body going, I guess, to see the ball going. I wanted to just come early to just visualize the game, you know what I mean? Because sometimes it gets hard to work on your game and get your shots up when everybody is shooting at the same time, you know what I mean? Mm. Basketball tend to hit at the same time, so I just wanted to get there early to focus. That's all it was.
You and Akeem, man, what did you guys eat for dinner?
Man.
Pre-game. Your energy just, you know.
Hey, I had a Subway sandwich. I don't know what Keem had, but I know I'm going to have a Subway sandwich in 2 days as well.
Yes.
Keem, he always tries to give that energy. I always try to give that energy. You know, I just think that everybody is individually focused to try to win. Mm-hmm. We all know what this means. We all know that I think no eight seed ever ended up beating the number one seed to go to the quarterfinals, you know, so. We just trying to do whatever we're trying to do, you know. It is what it is, man. We don't have any pressure. We came in this thing, nobody believed that we would be here. So we just believe in each other. And we know that we're men and we look ourselves in the mirror and we hold our head high every game, no matter what the outcome is. Tonight we just started night. We're just, you know, we're done celebrating about that, but we still gotta win another one.
If you can fix one thing for game two, what would you fix?
Probably controlling the lead.
Okay.
You know, we always get to that 7-8 point lead and then we end up letting it slip by like little small mental errors. If we can do a better job controlling that, then I think we'll have, you know, better chances because obviously, you know, Dale was a dangerous team and we can't just go bucket for bucket with them on their home court. So if we end up getting the lead in the next game, it's very important that we hold that lead, you know, going into the final minutes of the game.
What's the message though before game one in the locker room?
Man, you know, of course, I'm pretty sure you know about 70.
Yeah.
You know, we ended up losing them, preparing for this game. That's what I said, this preparation really meant a lot to us. We've been prepared as a team. We lost him, he couldn't play. Everybody was focused on him because we knew that our brother in arms couldn't go to war with us tonight. So we felt like we had to do our due diligence and come out here and play for him. And you know, every other Borneo fan, anybody that believes that we can win, that's what we're doing it for. You know, the people that believe that we're gonna lose, we never cared about them anyway. You know, they don't matter to us. You know, so it is what it is.
Vin, coba ceritain hari ini dari game plan dan juga dari start the game, kelihatannya memang kalian tuh mengutamakan energi kayaknya hari ini. Ya.
Hari ini sih energi Akeem nyalurin ke yang lainnya semuanya. Game plan ya kita antisipasi Jordan dari awal, kita
WiFi jangan dimatiin dulu ya.
Perketat Jordan terus dari awal. Ternyata olahraganya hari ini main bagus banget kan. Kuncinya sih dari kita main quarter 1-2 kita sempat main sendiri-sendiri. Masuk 3-4 mainnya kolektif. Mike bisa dapat 11 assist. Jadinya kita ya main kolektif bisa menang jadinya.
Kalau pemain import dan mungkin juga coaches ingetin ke pemain lokal apa sih untuk game hari ini?
Oh, dia kalau coaches sih ngingetin pemain lokal kayak ya ini harinya mau gimana pun ini anggap aja last game kalian. Jadi kalian mati-matian lah di lapangan.
Okay. Yo, don't go home yet. Gimana Uncle Akeem gimana hari ini mainnya?
Uncle save my turnover, dia selamatin turnover gua sih. Kalau dia enggak ada block itu sih gila. Gua bakal dihujar kayaknya.
Tapi lu ada beberapa 3 point. Lu sebagai pemain lokal ngerasa seberapa penting sih untuk step up selama playoff ini?
Ya, gua sama Calvin karena Safely juga cedera, gua sama Calvin emang udah harusnya step up lah, bantu asing-asing kita, udah dikasih Uncle, Mike, Steve, Jamar, kita harus bantu. Buktinya kita lumayan bisa ngebantu, makanya hari ini bisa dikasih kemenangan, masih satu game lagi.
Okay, thank you Orlando.
Let me start this off with just, I just want to give God all the glory. Without him we can't do nothing, with him we conquer all in front of us. I truly believe that. We believe bro, so we coming out here, look, we've been playing in the playoffs for the last 2-3 weeks. Every game we would have lost, we would have not been able to be here. So we used to the pressure now, you know, so this is like regular games for us. So we just playing hard and whatever happens, happens.
Akeem's gonna always show up in the playoff.
Got to.
The energy. just, you know, when you came into the game, what was your main focus?
Speed the game up.
Okay.
I think everybody knows that, you know, like the other team knows that. When I come in, it's me and Mike in there. Mike is looking at me like, all right, bro, rev up. Like, you know what I'm saying? Let's go. So he get the rebound. I'm going. I get the rebound. He's going. So I mean, we small. You know, we small. So small ball is playing in transition. And that's what we've been doing.
How about the block? How about that block?
Oh, man, not in my house, dog. Not in my house. Bro, hustle plays everything. You know what it is? It's playoffs. Every play matters. Every point matters. Every stop matters. So we got to put it all on the line.
Came early, man, like 3 hours before the game.
That's every game.
What was the reason, though?
Nah, it's every game. That's just my routine. I come early every time. I want to shoot the ball without any other balls hitting my basketball, you know. So that's my routine. That's my piece to get ready. And then, you know, feel good. You know, you got to feel good, feel comfortable out there. We don't practice here all the time, so I like to get as many shots up as possible in the house.
What did you see in Dewa's defense, though? You know, that you were able to drive to the lane, too, tonight.
Say all that. We ain't saying all of that. We in the playoffs, baby. We ain't saying all of that. We gonna keep doing what we do. They figure it out. We gotta adjust. They gotta adjust.
Coach Miles just told me that you and him breaking down films for the last 2 weeks, I think.
Yeah.
How important for you just to be involved, you know, giving him feedback?
Yeah. You know, I appreciate him so much. Mm-hmm. For a coach to trust you that much, to want to know what you think and stuff, every point guard in the world wants that type of relationship with their coach. Mm-hmm. And we got that type of relationship. If he don't agree with something, he's like, nah, I don't think so. You know, and we'll try different stuff out in practice, but man, his game planning has been, I told everybody, the stuff that he's been coming up with has been amazing. So he keep leading, he asks a little bit here, like, what you think? I tell him, but most of the time, it's just him. You know?
Jamar, Calvin, Orlando.
Energy.
Everybody step up, man.
Everybody stepped up. That pressure for the last 2 or 3 weeks of just every game is our last game mentality is just showing up now. Everybody's just showing up. We're used to the pressure, you know? So these guys are just, and everybody's working crazy hard too. Coming early, staying late. So man, we want it. We want it.
Game two, gonna be toughest closeout game.
All closeout games are tough, and that's a great team out there. That's a great team. They're number one for a reason, and we give them their respect, you know? But, you know, we men too, you know what I mean? And we want it just as bad as they do, or maybe more. So we're going to keep fighting every day.
Okay, now it's time for you to promote your merch, bro.
Yeah, man. Hello. Hello, man. Y'all see it online. Go to How Before You on Instagram. Go get you a shirt. How Before You Eat, man, just to remind you to keep hunting after your dreams, you know? Speak it, prepare for it, work on your craft, and then when the opportunity comes, make sure you eat.
Just background, though, of the design. You got, like,
is it batik?
It's batik right here. Uh-huh. To represent Indonesia, you know what I'm saying? I've been here for a little minute. Respect to Indonesia. I love being here. I love the cuisine, the weather, the people, the hoop. So I want to make sure we got some batik in there and then batik on the back as well.
I appreciate you, man. Good luck, man. Yes, sir. Thank you, bro.
I know the rules. Before you eat.